r/askreddit by Reddit and chill. What is the biggest waste of money? Any food or drinks with gold flakes. It does nothing for the taste. It's about the aesthetics. I want my vomit to shimmer. So I drink gold sklidger. Those stimulation stomach belts that tell you it will give you six-pack abs. People just don't use them right. They should be glued on permanently, and when a person puts junk in their mouth, the belt gives them a 50V shot. Counterintuitive, but buying cheap stuff to save money and then having to buy it again or pay for reparation. Example: appliances, shoes and furniture. Edit. Spelling. Cheap shoes can hurt your feet, ankles, knees etc., leading to expensive medical appointments. Completely agree here. Tobacco. I can't believe how much I have spent by smoking. Every month I end up without money for all the cigarettes I buy. I hate it and hate myself for getting addicted. When my brother told me how much he spends on 2 cartons a week, one for him and one for his wife, I almost fainted. It was like $550 a month. SMDH. Smoking. You're literally burning your money away. And your life. Funerals. When I die, just throw me in the trash. Fallout 76 membership. So true. Timeshares or any MLM program. We signed up for a timeshare presentation in Las Vegas because they offered a steep discount on a good hotel room if we went. I've never been to one before, but they did not like me one bit by the time they were shoving us out the door. Lots of crap happened in that 2 hours while they try to butter your roll. But the main takeaway is that they wanted us to buy into some medium package for $80,000. But don't you worry your pretty little head. They can offer you a loan for only 17% interest. But this amazing offer was only good right then. We couldn't leave and think about it. They were quick to point that out. I laughed in their faces. By our rough estimates later, we would have been looking at paying $1,000 a month. We weren't going to buy anything anyways and told them that at the beginning. They smugly told us everyone says that, but most people buy in. I know most people don't because I researched it before we went. But didn't say that at the time. They just kept fibbing, lying, exaggerating through the whole presentation. And MLMs are predatory. Cult-like. And 99% of people lose money. They can kiss my butt. Buying WinRAR. Especially since 7-Zip is free and open source. Endless foreign wars. Foreign wars that end quickly aren't cheap either. Saving loads of it without ever investing. Please tell this to my dad. Has £650k in savings but keeps complaining that it won't get him as much as it used to. Oh. And the stock market is a scam and will steal all of his money apparently. Gambling. Specifically luck-based gambling. You can actually be good at poker, for example, and win money. But shit like roulette and slot machines are mathematically guaranteed to make you lose money in the long run. Scratch-off lotto tickets. And smoking. War. What is it good for? An education for a degree you didn't end up using but whose loans you are still paying off. Not price comparing. Why buy the same thing for more? I buy stuff for more at my local game store because I want to support them. Because they host events and I give a shit about them. Throwing a lavish wedding. I get that people want to make the day special. But you can still have a very nice wedding without breaking the bank. Instead of spending so much on the wedding, you can use that money to help get your new life together as a married couple off to a great start. Yes. I'm always baffled by co-workers and friends who spend $30-70k on a wedding. Including $4-5k for a dress that gets used one time. Spending money on the movie Cats tickets. Disagree. That movie gave me my hardest laughs of 2019. What do you mean it's not a comedy? Lottery tickets. Hey. I spent $2 on a week's worth of fantasizing and dreaming. If I paid for hope, then I got my money's worth. More than one ticket though. Yeah, a total waste. Driving a giant diesel pickup truck for daily transportation. Towing heavy things with underpowered vehicles is also wasteful and dangerous. But how many of those diesel trucks are actually ever going to tow anything? Cocaine. As I usually paired it with excessive drinking and gambling, it cost me even more than it normally would. Since I have been clean, I always have money. And I enjoy the effects of that far more than I ever enjoyed the blow. Cable TV. There are so many streaming options out there that cost a fraction of what cable costs. I second this. Never had it. Never needed it. Now that I'm an adult and can buy it, I'm absolutely not going to. Way too expensive just to mostly watch commercials. Sex dolls. Use your hand like an adult. Reminds me of the time when my former roommate moved out and we found the instruction booklet for his sex doll in the closet. He was living on the couch, so I guess we figured out why he would spend 2-3 hours in the bathroom every day. Using premium fuel if your car does not require it. This entirely depends on newer engines. The vehicle can basically tune itself to take advantage of using the higher octane with variable valve timing. On regular days, it's a waste. But if you're planning on squeezing extra performance and running the engine hard, a tank of the next level octane could be helpful. Also, if you live in the Eastern 1/3 of Colorado, don't use the cheapest level of gas. That 85 octane will probably be okay. But if anything happens, the manufacturer will tell you that you put the wrong gas in the motor. Screw Colorado making huge taxes off of people not knowing better about octane ratings. You can get 87 octane for the same price as 85 octane just by crossing the border to Kansas. Most people don't even realize this. And I don't know of any manufacturer that says 85 octane is safe in their vehicles. Even at altitude. Drinking is a pretty hardcore money drain. I was in a cult for decades that asked for 10% of my income every time I got paid. If I didn't pay it, I couldn't access the super secret magic rituals that would let me into heaven. Also, they asked me to work for them in a foreign country. For free. For 2 years, convincing other people to join the cult. I was supposed to pay my own way. While this wasn't exactly considered necessary to get into super extra heaven, it was heavily implied that it would help. Also that my future spouse would be better looking if I did it. Turns out my money, and the money of millions of others, is now sitting in a tax-free $100 billion investment fund. Diamonds and by extension, the whole wedding industry. The new lab-created ones are pretty damn nice and are not expensive at all. Alcohol at clubs. $15 for a drink in New York City. Flasking is the move. I was at Encore for a beach party in Vegas. $70 a drink. Cigarettes. In-game purchases in apps. Yo, I've never understood that. You're basically paying to play a game less. Game skins. Never understood the appeal. The end game of every game is who looks the coolest. Big fancy weddings and expensive honeymoons, unless you're absolutely filthy rich. Get married at City Hall. Put a down payment on a house and/or invest wisely in a retirement fund. Cigarettes. 2. I will say there is a medium ground between a fancy wedding and marriage at City Hall. A wedding can act as a giant party for all the people you care about most. Done correctly, it is a joyous time and treasured memory. But that doesn't require more than a location and music. ID cards or certification purchased online to make your pet into a service animal or emotional support animal. They are all scams. No exceptions. Service animal laws vary from country to country. And even by state or province. But there is nowhere in the world that recognizes some random thing you bought online that doesn't even evaluate your dog's training or your medical need for animal assistance. Most of them won't even verify it's an animal and not a jar of Nutella. Literally. There's a jar of Nutella registered with the United States Service Dog Registry. Don't be fooled by the name. The USSDR has no affiliation to the government. And they aren't the only website using official looking shit to trick people. Far from it. TV evangelists. Starbucks. And not cooking at home but eating out or having food delivered all the time. Reminds me of people I used to work with. Every day they'd turn up to the office with breakfast bought from the downstairs cafe. Which would probably be about $10, including a coffee. So there's $50 a week. Then at lunch they'd scurry off to buy whatever from the local takeaways. Likely coming in at about $15 to $20. So there's another $75 a week minimum. These were the same people who complained about being broke. Always saying they had to borrow money or get extensions to pay bills. And so on. Yet they were horrified and offended when I suggested perhaps they could eat bring in breakfast from home and do the same for lunch. Things like Supreme, Jordans and all these pieces of clothing where you pay for the brand and not the clothing. God, I hate hippie beasts. It's worth it if you can get the stuff at retail and flip it to the people willing to spend money on it. My cousin bought $150 Nike shoes and sold them for over $1,000. Not a bad gig if you can get your hands on them. Bottled water. Gym memberships that you buy at New Year's and then don't use. Prostitutes who aren't looking like Danny DeVito. Every ducking thread. The Iraq War. Big weddings. Game of Thrones season 8. Logan Paul merch. Definitively Logan Paul merch. My entire college tuition and other non-essentials. Actually, my entire life TBH. Cigarettes in the year 2020. It is strange. But I actually see young people smoking. WTF. I remember reading Stranger Things had to reduce the smoking scenes because of the impressionable effects it was having. But seriously. In 2020 with all the information we have? The smokers waste so much money on cigarettes and they are killing their lungs and circulatory system. Buying the cheapest version of something. It stops working or falls apart in 10x less time. Or it works like crap to begin with. That knockoff brand shoe looks the same as the real one. But costs 25% less than the original? Be prepared to be uncomfortable after walking for a while. Then see it fall apart after 6 months instead of 5 years. There's a non-stick pan at Target that costs $20. Instead of $50 at Bed Bath & Beyond? Watch it work like shit after the second use. What's the point of spending any money on something if it doesn't work right? Buy a quality one and you won't have to replace it in 6 months. If you get a quality version and keep it for 5 years, you get 10 times the use of it and only pay 25% more. Ducking, like, and subscribe.